Story of a haunted fire hall. We have vampires, three in fact, from the TV series Forever Night. We have bats, still to come, more spooky stuff. The vampires from the TV series Forever Night. Also, those winged Halloween theme. We have three actors who play vampires on the television show Forever Night, which premiered this past Tuesday night on CFTO TV in Toronto. Please welcome the Bloodsuckers, Garrett Wynn Davis, Nigel Bennett, and Deborah Duchenne.
Shake your hand. Sure. Hi, 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 hi.
I sat at home last night watching the, it's a 1 hour opening, so we've just seen the first half hour here in Canada, and my son and I watched it. Nicholas had never seen it. It was kind of, well, I don't know. Anyway, at the end of the first half hour, he's glued to it. It is extremely well done, and I congratulate you on it. It has been running in the United States of America for a while already.
Since May.
Yeah.
And how is it doing down there?
Very well.
Yeah.
It's in a section called Crime Time After Prime Time, which is late at night.
Isn't that unusual to start something in the U.S. and then bring it here? One would have thought started the other way, but...
Actually, it was CBS had originally produced it for this late night slot. It's at 11:30. What happens is, it's called, as Nigel said, Crime Time After Prime Time. It's their way of competing with the talk shows, the late night talk shows, like Letterman and things like that. And so they started this drama hour segment, and so they specifically produce our show for that, and Glenn Warren and the gang are showing it up here.
You do great vampires. These are three vampires. I mean, they all play vampire roles. And you are bilingual. I don't know, why do all vampires speak French?
It's in the blood.
It's in the blood. But why is it? Is there a reason for it? Because you're all from...
It's continental, it's European, it's different. Yeah. It's not Transylvanian, but it's the idea is that Nigel is the boss, you see. Nigel is he's the one who brought us over.
That's what you say, brought us over, meaning
yes,
into the side of immortality.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You brought both of these.
But Deb is the one who sort of got me into the room.
I don't know why he turned me down.
Did it.
You know,
he
I don't
actually
know why.
Did it, yeah. Yes.
But to make somebody a vampire, you can just sort of take their blood, or you can make them a vampire. These are different processes.
You have to stop at a certain time, and that's the problem. It's control.
Yeah.
You have to stop before the heart stops beating, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But you get so carried away. Why am I telling you this?
Well, no, I was just wondering.
I read the Anne Rice books, and I was so fascinated by them, as like a lot of people were. Why are we so fascinated by vampires?
It's so rich.
Because they pay us.
But why are so we fascinated by you who get paid so well? Is it because...
Well, isn't it the dark side, like we're fascinated with people on motorcycles and things in leather and all that? It's that kind of living to the edge, on the edge and all that stuff. And it's a very sexual thing as well.
It's a very erotic thing.
Yes, very erotic.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, nobody... I never connected vampirism with eroticism. I mean, it never sort of made a lot of sense to me until you... Why is it such an erotic experience?
Well, it's a position nobody's tried.
But if something else happens, though, supposedly, when you take the blood, you get into the heart rhythm or something? You get lost?
Yeah, the heart rhythms are supposed to become synchronous with each other.
What was that?
Yeah, it's like... simultaneous, whatever.
Combustion.
Combustion.
I also thought that the great charm of it was the factor of immortality. You guys are immortal, but one of the interesting things is it's quite boring. You make a comment in the one I saw about, oh, you know, who are you now? Here we are again.
And... Yeah, and baseball games seem to go on forever.
Could you imagine being renewed for your 800th year? I mean, your 800 years of Dini Petty Show would be great.
Unfortunately, a lot of you may not have caught it because it's only played once here, but it's really an extraordinary a series. It is called Forever Night. That's K-N-I-G-H-T. And we're just going to show you a little clip. In this clip, Lacroix, played by Nigel Bennett, is asking Nick, played by Garrett, I have this thing with your first name. I have this mental block.
I'll read it.
Come on the show. No, we had a meeting. People wrote it on cards for me. I rehearsed it. This is Billy. Mr. Davies. Garrett.
Yes.
Wynn Davies. See, I said it. And here he is. We're going to see Nick, played by Mr. Davies, and why he is denying, in this part, he's denying his vampire past.
Do you remember, Nicholas? Do you remember that night centuries ago? That first night when you became one of us? Did her heart sound strong? Did it call to you and make you dizzy with the first rush of her warm blood? How can you turn your back on what you've been given?
Is this another vampire murder?
Oh, come on. You're not going to call them that, eh?
What guilt is this that drives you to become an officer of the law? Go around. Around. Now, what the hell's around? What folly is this that you aspire to be mortal again?
It is the blood that keeps you from coming over.
I caught a killer tonight in paying my debt.
You can be human.
What turn of the heart that compels you to seek mortal love?
Say that everything in our future can be found in our past.
No. It's too easy a place to hide.
Hold me.
No, I can't.
The security from the museum?
I kissed her. And then I nearly killed her.
Someone's been killing the homeless with type O blood.
This is not your fault.
It's my fault, Matt. It's my fault.
One of the victims had punctures in his neck.
Is this something that I should worry about?
Is it me, Nicholas?
He hasn't been making these kills, if that's what you think.
Nowadays, nobody is that stupid.
Is it you? I have the answers, Nicholas. I have the other cup.
It could, in fact, be the cure for vampirism.
And he believes that if you perform this ceremony, you can become mortal again.
We both do.
Are you coming, Nicholas? I have what you want.
This is his way of calling me out, Nat.
Are you there, Nicholas? Are you coming? The night crawlers waiting for you.
It's really good. It's really good, guys.
That's the link between one and two.
It really is good. It really draws you in. Do they do something to your teeth? I know, obviously, when you get the fangs,
We all have very sharp incisors. That's how we got them.
They're all made for all of us, and we've got these eyes that we put in that are hand-painted from Germany, which are really bizarre.
Is that what they are? They're
contacts.
Yeah. Can you actually see with the monitor? They're designed so you can see?
Over the course of time, it gets a lot easier, but we did do a lot of sort of bumping into people. It was a good way to meet people, actually. Strangers that they should meet. Anyway, it took a little time, but it's very yellow and it's very narrow. The little sort of visual
spot.
The
vision is very small.
There are little holes in the center, aren't there? So you can see.
Now, you finished for the year. You started in March of this year, and you've done your how many episodes?
22.
22. So you're now off for a bit of a break.
We finished principal photography last Friday, basically. Well, it went on. But, so now we're just tying up the loose ends.
So the story is, just give us a bit of the story here, seeing as you're the head vampire. How does this all sort of go together for overnight?
Well, I made him. He's my little boy over there, and this is my little girl. And we've been vaguely unhappy in the way that families are for hundreds of years. And it's like adolescent rebellion. He now wants to be different from Dad. And he's trying to give it up. He's trying to give up vampirism and atone for his past sins. And I don't want him to do that. He's my little boy.
And in order to give this up and atone, you've decided to become a police officer.
Yes, that's the way that he's living in this life, to sort of give back to the society that he's been taking away from.
To make up for the killings he did, he's now catching killers.
Supposedly he hasn't killed anyone in 100 years. He drinks cow blood. Do you remember telling that before?
He does. He drinks cow blood. Cow blood. Bottles in the fridge.
Yes. Yeah. It's amazing. Going into the butchers takes a new sort of take on it. But so he does that, and he works with the person who was Catherine Disher, who plays the forensic scientist and the mortician, or no, the not mortician. What am I saying?
No, they call the person the morgue. Morgue
person.
The morgue person.
Come on, Mary.
Forensic.
Who are they?
Forensic scientist.
Thank you. Oh, we said, okay, that's
forensic doctor.
Pathologist?
Pathologist. Is
Thank
that
you.
It?
That's it. On the nose. Perfect.
What was the story?
Anyhow, what was the story? So she tries to help Nick
you.
With different things, like feeding him certain foods and good food types and things like that will help him become more mortal so that he can indeed stop eating cow's blood.
Or go back to his sinful ways. Now, you've arrived. You've caught up with him.
Mm.
And you're trying to say, now look, straighten out, kid. Come back to the fold, as it were. And
yeah. I spend a lot of time telling him that he's wasting his time trying to change.
The fascination with vampires is just extraordinary. I guess Anne Rice probably started with her trilogy. But now, is it Francis Ford Coppola that's bringing up the new vampire?
There's three. Bram Stoker. He was the original writer.
No, I don't know if the movie, because I just heard, I have those books on tapes. And I heard Bram Stoker's version of it, and it's quite different than any other story I've ever heard. Is the movie based, is it true to the original?
It opens next week or this weekend or something.
I believe it is very true.
It's a very cyclical thing, the vampire phenomenon. I mean, it comes in and out, it goes in waves, and we just happen to be at in the middle of one right now, which is really good for timing of a television program,
perfect.
Of course. I mean, so but what's funny, though, of course, is my son is dressing up as a vampire on Saturday, and you just think,
for Halloween.
Guys, I mean, your dad's a doctor, you become a doctor. You don't become a vampire.
How old is the child?
He's six.
There's got to be some great lines. And why are you wearing that? Well, you see my dad.
Yes, my daughter was going to go as Jeanette, but I said no.
Said, there's a limit to everything here. Do you have people when you, in the U.S., or have you been recognized? Do you get odd reaction from people?
We get a lot of response, a lot of mail from people. Supposedly, it was said, I don't know these things, but it was said that by the president of CBS that we received more letters of fan mail, or whatever one calls it, than any of the other shows on late night. And I think it's because, I mean, it's a good show and everything, but I think it's because of the vampire lore. People are really, really attracted to that kind of thing. And good God, I've been offered Rottweilers. I mean, people.
Have you really?
Yes. The weird thing, I mean, you know, normally people send you a box of chocolate just to eat as a new food group.
Yes.
But it's weird. So I get dogs, war dogs, and things like that. I mean, as if, really, I mean.
But do they, I mean, yes, I mean, there are a lot of strange people in the world. And if you've talked to anyone who's been involved with, say, Star Trek, I mean, there are people who really call them to say they've had messages and they're quite sincere. And I would imagine you'll attract that same sort of.
But there are also a lot of people who watch it and just really enjoy the fantastic elements of it, so that they're intrigued by it also just being a different type of programming on the air. So it's just not a police show. It's not just a whatever. And because it's quite real. And then we just take these leaps of fancy. And what happens with Nigel Debb and myself is each story flashes back into some of the 800 years that we've sort of been together. And so you've got the police drama, and suddenly you flash back. I do this, by the way. Where's the camera? This is what I do. You'll see it every week.
Okay.
Suddenly you're in the middle of a sentence, and when I do this, you know that we're going to go back. Right? Suddenly the guy just looks glazed, and he flashes back. But so you've seen it here first. And we go back into a little story where we were fighting, wherever we've been, to England, we've been to America, we've been all over
everywhere.
We fought the Confederate War.
And there's a lovely thing that happens with the coloring and the lighting. When you go back 800 years, it has a real nice feeling to it, real nice quality.
The whole look of the show is wonderful. It's one of the things that makes it quite unique.
Are you already renewed for next year? I mean, this is your first year, but you've been playing in the States. It's a big success. Do you know? You're back, I assume.
The indications are good. They don't have to let us know until later. So what we're all doing is, Nigel's going to make a lot more money doing a lot more things. Deb is doing the same, and I'm going away to hide.
So. That's right. Nigel's taking. Nigel, the two of you are going to do work, but you're heading off to
Bali.
Bali.
Yes.
Taking the kids and the whole family and going to Bali
long? Well, until February at least.
What a smart man you are. I think that's what a wise decision.
Good, huh?
Yeah.
And you're good, eh? And people ask you, why did you become an actor? I don't know.
How does one audition to be a vampire? I mean, did you have to do any, like, vampire things, or did you know?
We had to audition, yeah.
But
yeah.
Necking on the casting couch.
Did you have to do anything rather different in this audition?
Well, I mean, if you call standing and going different, then yes, it's different.
You do that actually very well. Is that sort of?
Well, I've practiced a lot. You know?
I had to do an improvisation for 5 minutes about drinking blood.
It was get out of here.
Yeah, it was the most bizarre thing. You're in a room with the producer and the director, etc., and suddenly you've got a coffee cup, and they say, okay, now you're going to be a vampire and you have to drink blood. And what you do for 5 minutes is come up with whatever you can in 3 seconds that you would do if you were going to flip out over a glass of blood. Well, it was. I saw the audition tape last week. Woo! I don't know how I got the job personally.
You had to do this for 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah, it went on and on. As a matter
and
of fact,
you didn't know. This was like a complete surprise.
Oh, yeah, just making it all up. And they wouldn't turn off the camera, so I had to actually exit the room to stop the scene and close the door. That's the last thing you need to do. Come on back in. It's okay.
No, I'm not coming in.
Turn off the camera.
Yeah,
when you saw the 5-minute tape of you, did you say anything that you thought was, looking back, was quite humorous? Or?
Well, I did a lot of this. I did a lot of hair acting. I don't know.
I do that.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, Nige does a lot of that.
It really is an excellent show. It runs on Tuesday nights on CFTO-TV. It is called, you'll see it across the country in the CTV network, Tuesday nights at 10, and it's called Forever Night. And we thank you very much for being with
us. Happy Halloween.
Coming up next. Coming up next, those winged creatures of the night. Bats. I think he likes you, Mary.